आज का हमारा टॉपिक है गैमेटोजेनेसिस। गैमेटोजेनेसिस, व्हाट इज द गैमेटोजेनेसिस? गैमेटोजेनेसिस इज द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ गैमेट्स। गैमेट्स प्रोड्यूस और फॉर्म होने का जो प्रोसेस है दैट इज गैमेटोजेनेसिस। व्हाट आर द गैमेट्स? गैमेट्स इज नथिंग बट द स्पर्म, दैट इज एन नंबर। गैमेट्स ऑलवेज इन एन नंबर। ओवम इज ऑल्सो एन नंबर। दिस इज द मेल गैमेट, दिस इज द फीमेल गैमेट। सो फॉर्मेशन ऑफ गैमेट, सो व्हाई द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ गैमेट और द गैमेटोजेनेसिस इज रिक्वायर्ड, व्हाट इज द रीजन बिहाइंड इट? क्या जरूरत पड़ती है गैमेटोजेनेसिस की हमको, इसके लिए गैमेटोजेनेसिस होता है। तो गैमेटोजेनेसिस कब होता है? क्योंकि हम लोग जानते हैं कि हर स्पेसीज जो है, हर स्पेसीज का अपना एक फिक्स नंबर है, फिक्स क्रोमोसोम नंबर है, फिक्स क्रोमोसोम नंबर। जैसे ह्यूमन बीइंग, अगर ह्यूमन बीइंग की बात करेंगे तो हमारे फिक्स क्रोमोसोम नंबर है 46, और उसको हम कैसे डिनोट करते हैं? इट इज डिनोटेड बाय द 2n नंबर, मींस द डिप्लॉयड नंबर। इट्स अ डिप्लॉयड 2n नंबर, दैट इज द ह्यूमन बीइंग्स फिक्स नंबर। तो ईच एंड एवरी स्पेसीज फिक्स देयर क्रोमोसोम नंबर। हाउ इट कैन बी फिक्स? सपोज दिस इज अ मेल पेरेंट, दिस इज अ फीमेल पेरेंट इन ह्यूमन बीइंग, मेल एंड फीमेल। ह्यूमन बीइंग मीन्स 2n नंबर, दैट इज 46, दिस इज ऑल्सो 2n नंबर। सपोज इज अ स्पर्म and ovum, gametes, and they unite and they will form again the offspring, that is 2n number. So this 2n number and this 2n number, when combines together, they will form the 4n number. But now it not happen like that only. In the new progeny, that's a restore that the number of chromosome by the process of meiosis, by the process of meiosis. So what is meiosis? We know very well about the meiosis. Meiosis is the reduction division. Meiosis is the reduction division which reduces the chromosome number, which reduces half number, that is n number. It produces the haploid structure, that is sperm and ovum. So that is the meiosis. And this, after meiosis, that it gets the n number. Here also ovum gets the n number. And when the combination of this n and n again restoring the chromosome number in that new progeny is nothing but the restoring of the fertilization. And if gametogenesis is important when the restore of the chromosome number. Now it is of two type, that is for sperm formation it is to be called spermatogenesis. And if formation of ovum is there, female gametes, that is oogenesis. So this is a two types of gametogenesis, that is a spermatogenesis means to form sperm, oogenesis to form ovum or the egg cell. It is may called it egg cell. So today we will see the spermatogenesis. Spermatogenesis, formation of sperm. Formation of male gametes. So spermatogenesis is nothing but formation of male gametes, and it started from the germinal epithelium. कहां से स्टार्ट होने वाले? जर्मिनल एपिथेलियम से। हाइपोथैलेमस एट द टाइम ऑफ द प्यूबर्टी दिस हाइपोथैलेमस सीक्रेट्स GnRH, गोनाडोट्रोपिन रिलीज हार्मोन। इट्स नेम इज gonadotropin release hormone. It initiate what is the role of GnRH? It initiate the secretion of which hormone? FSH, follicle stimulating hormone. Means this initiate the FSH, and FSH induces, it induces the spermatogenesis. This is the exact mechanism of the spermatogenesis. First, the germinal epithelium are important for secretion of gonadotropin release hormone, which initiate the follicle stimulating hormone, which induce the process of spermatogenesis. Means pila hormone, gonadotropin release hormone are initiated to FSH, and then secretion of FSH induces the spermatogenesis. Now there are complete process in a three way or the three different steps. So what are the three different steps? First is the multiplication phase. Multiplication phase. Second is growth phase. And third one is maturation phase. So this is the primordial cell. First, primordial cell, which is 2n number. अब ये प्रीमोडियल सेल कहाँ होता है? तो प्रीमोडियल सेल, दिस इज अ सपोज दिस इज अ टीएस ऑफ टेस्टिस, दिस इज अ सेमिनिफेरस ट्यूब्यूल, दिस इज स्ट्रक्चर यू नो वेरी वेल अबाउट द टीएस ऑफ टेस्टिस. दिस इज अ सेमिनिफेरस ट्यूब्यूल. So seminiferous tubules, these are tubules with ducts. It's a ducts, tubules, and its outer thin layer, single celled, is the germinal epithelium. So germinal epithelium, this is. So outer lining, which is single thin layer, is present on the tube, that is seminiferous tubules. Outer side lining is cuboidal in shape. They are cuboidal in shape. Cuboidal in shape, germinal epithelium, and that primordial cell is nothing but that germinal epithelium. It divides. And redivides by the repeated mitosis. By the process of mitosis. Mitosis is applied here. This primordial cell, which is on the outer lining of the seminiferous tubule, it goes undergoes mitosis. Repeated divisions of mitosis gives rise to this, that is spermatogonia. These sperm, they form the large number of, when primordial cells goes under mitosis, it undergo mitosis, it gives a large number of spermatogonia, but a some amount of the spermatogonia are not redivides. Rest are redivide. Process is going on and on. But some of the spermatogonia are increase their size. See, it's a small, it's a big one. By accumulation of food material. And it enlarges and increase their size. It is the name is primary spermatozoids. Spermatocytes. It is also 2n number. That spermatogonia is also 2n number. Diploid. So primordial cell is also diploid 2n number. Spermatogonia is also 2n number. Primary spermatocyte 2n, because meiosis is not starting here. That's why this same structure after mitosis, same number 2n number. Now this primary spermatocytes again divide by meiosis. By meiosis, as you know that meiosis have two part, meiosis first and meiosis two. So meiosis first, and it produces the haploid number of the primary spermatozoite, and this is called secondary. After the meiosis, it is called secondary spermatozoites. So there are two structures. Primary spermatocyte is the large one, large size, accumulation of food, and the second one is again meiosis one. And after, they also shows. Meiosis two. As you know that meiosis two is just like a mitosis. Four haploid cells. This process is just like a mitosis. And what happened in mitosis? Four number of cell forms. So all these are four numbers, and that are called as spermatids. These are called as spermatid. Abhi tak sperm nahi bana hai. Primordial cell, then spermatogonia, then primary spermatocyte, then secondary spermatocyte, then spermatids. Then spermatids are responsible for the sperm, and they remain attached with the Sertoli cell. Sertoli cell is here. It attached with the Sertoli cell, and they are attached in all the cells are attached, interlinked with each other, and this is a sperm cell, and the head of the sperms are just attached to this spermatids, and then finally they form the spermatozoa. It is also called a spermatozoa, or its name is sperm. Finally they reach to the process of sperm. So this is whole about, and now these three steps, yes, these three step multiplication phase. So this is the this step from primordial to this one. This is the multiplication phase, first one, that is a multiplication of multiplication phase, and this some cell are converting into the primary spermatocyte. This is the second step, that is the growth phase. That is the growth phase. And what is third? From the growth phase to the sperm, there is a third stage. So these three phases, first of all primordial cell, three steps. First step is multiplication of phase. What is actually happening in multiplication of cell? Multiplication of cell mein kya hone wala hai? Primordial cell undergoes repeated divisions of mitosis, and they form the huge large number of spermatogonia, which is also 2n number, and then some of the spermatogonia are stop repeating and enlarges their size, and accumulation of food where takes place. That's why its size is increased and its structure is also increased, and that structure is called as primary spermatocytes, which is also 2n number, because meiosis is still not started. Now here meiosis started in the third stage, that is the maturation phase. After meiosis one, it gives the two haploid cells, that is the secondary spermatocyte, which is n in number, which is n in number. So, and second meiosis, as you know that second meiosis is always the copy of the mitosis. So second meiosis, second again applied, and then form the spermatid, four haploid cells, that is a spermatid. And a spermatid when formed, then this is a lumen of that seminiferous tubule. This is a lumen. This is a seminiferous tubule, and central part is a lumen. Lumen of that, they are released by the spermatids, and they detach after the action of the mitosis and the endoplasmic reticulum. So this is all about the spermatogenesis. In next slide or in the next video, I will explain the oogenesis. Thank you.